Good evening everyone, once again welcome to our shiur on the parasha. Tonight we're studying parashat Bereshit. This shiur is dedicated in memory of all the Jews that were armed and killed in the past week in Eretz Israel. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu revenge their neshamot, their soul, and give a quick refuah shelema to the ones that were armed. Especially today for Neor Selav Ben Rut, a young boy who stand a month before his bar mitzvah and was stabbed today by an Arab. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu give him a quick refuah shelema. So like we just said, we're standing today in very difficult days. Very difficult days. Difficult for Am Israel. Although we live in America and we look, we seem to be more secured, but we still have to feel bad for our brother in Eretz Israel. We have to feel their pain. Like today, someone showed me the video how an Arab was stabbing policemen. For 2 hours, I couldn't eat. I couldn't talk, I couldn't do anything. I feel so bad for them. We have to feel the pain. Although we live in America, we have to feel the pain of our brother in Eretz Israel. I have my brother, he's married, his children, he's afraid to go to the supermarket. They are afraid to go outside. They are afraid to go outside. So we have to feel bad for them as much as possible to pray that Kadosh Baruch Hu should send them Yeshuot. And if you see, through history, our nation suffers so much. And all the historian, all the wise people of the world always try to understand what is the secret of our nation. What the secret of Am Israel? Like we said, Am Israel, Chaim v'Kayam. Right? What is the secret of our nation? We went through so many pogroms, so many holocausts, so many attacks, so many galuyot, so many exile. Million and million and million of Jews were killed. Bet HaMikdash HaRishon, Bet HaMikdash HaSheni, then we have the Inquisition, then we have the Holocaust, and now the terrorist attack in Eretz Israel. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of thousands of Jews were killed. Not only that, our nation is a small nation. Small nation. What is a koach? What is a power? What give Bnei Israel the koach to keep going? Look around. This big nation, right? Biggest nation, that the Jewish nation, that are not around. The Romans, the Yevanim, the Greece. He had a strong, wealthy kingdom, France, with all their kings, Louis, 1, 2, 3. They're all gone. They're all gone. In England, finished. The king today has no power, just nice for the pictures, right? Germany was so strong, nothing left from it. They're all gone, those countries. So how come Bnei Israel, that are not wealthy, they are not as strong, they are not as big as other nations, they're still around? What is the secret of Am Israel? And the Goyim can understand what is our koach. It says in the Holocaust, in Auschwitz, in the same place, you had two people, one Jew and one Russian, a big Russian. The Jew was an old man, skinny and short. And next to him, he had this giant Russian, with the muscle all over, healthy. After 2 weeks, he snapped. After 2 weeks, he couldn't make it, he got killed. And the Jew over there, the old Jew, skinny and weak, he was able to go through all the Holocaust and survive. What was the koach, what was the secret of this Jew? And the answer is emuna. We have something the goyim don't have. It's emuna, faith in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The Jew in the Holocaust, although he was skinny, although he was weak, although he was almost with nothing, but he knew that he has a Kadosh Baruch Hu with him. All the time he was suffering, he felt, Hashem is holding my hand. Hashem is with me. And that's the difference between us and Goyim. The difference is that we have emuna. We have emuna that a Kadosh Baruch Hu is with us, is holding our hand. Goyim, they don't have that. They don't have that. They might be wealthy. They might be strong nation. They might be big kingdom. But when you don't have emuna, you're left with nothing. Emuna and klum. Someone doesn't have faith, he has nothing. Someone that has emuna, im yesh emuna, yesh hakol. When a person has emuna, he has everything. Why? Because without emuna, the first test that comes, you're finished. You're dead. But when you have emuna, even though you might go through nisyonot, through difficult time, you could survive. That's emuna. And last week, I was talking to someone, and he asked me, Rabbi, where and when I could talk to God. Where and when I could talk to Hashem. I told him, whenever you want, and wherever you want, and the way you want. You don't have to call Hashem for a meeting. You want to talk to Hashem in your car. Put the car on park and start talking to Hashem. Hashem, please, it's difficult. Please help me. You could talk to Hashem wherever you want, whenever you want, right? You fly the plane right there in the cloud. You could look up in Shamayim and talk to Hashem. You're driving your car, put it on park. Now when you're driving, and said, talk to Hashem. Close your eyes and say, Hashem, please help me with my Shalom Bayit. Hashem, please help me in Parnasa. Hashem, please help me with my children. Hashem, help me to be a better Jew. That's Emunah. Emunah is to believe that Hashem is always holding you by your hand. When you have to feel I'm a little boy, a little child, you're holding his hand, he's holding Hashem's hands. When you walk during the day, when you walk outside during the day, you have to imagine Hashem is holding my hand and he's the one that is lending me during my life. That's the secret of Bnei Israel. So what exactly Emunah does? What exactly Emunah does to a person? He gets me close to Hashem. Very nice. But what does Emunah do? So I want to share with you an amazing Gemara. It says in the Gemara, Darash Rabbi Simlai. Rabbi Simlai said, Gemara in Makot 23b. At the beginning, Moshe Rabbeinu gave Bnei Israel 613 mitzvot. 613 mitzvot. Like he said, Torah Tziva Lanu Moshe Morasha, Keilat Yaakov. Torah, Gematria 611. Plus two mitzvot that were given by Hashem, the first two Diberot, all together 613. 613 mitzvot were given by Moshe Rabbeinu. Comes the Gemara, and the Gemara says, later on, came David HaMelech, and Emidan al 11. Rashi explained that David HaMelech saw that the Jewish people cannot keep 613 mitzvot, it's too much. Too much, 613 mitzvot. What do you want? He said, you know what? Only 11. Let's do only 11. Came the other rabbi and said, you know what? Only 6. Come another rabbi and said, only 3. Come another rabbi and said, only 2. Came the last Navi, Habakkuk, ve'emidan al-achat. He said, you know what? Keep the mitzvah off. He says, ve'tzadik, be'muna yichye. Be'muna to yichye. Explain the ma'achsha, emuna. Explain the Rashi. Rashi explain. What does it mean, 11 mitzvot? שבתחילה היו צדיקים. At the beginning, the Jewish people, they were צדיקים, great people. היו יכולים לקבל all מצוות הרבה. They could have kept the whole Torah, 613 מצוות. אבל דורות האחרונים, the later generation, לא היו צדיקים כל כך. They were not so holy, they were not so righteous. ואם באו לשמור כולם, and if they would have to keep all the מצוות, there is no one person that could keep all the Torah. Come David HaMelech said, you know what, only 11. Came the prophet, until at the end, Habakkuk said, only Emunah. So what does it mean? I don't have to keep Shabbat? I don't have to keep Kasher? Only Emunah, Chaz v'Shalom. Explain the Mefarshim, the following, like this. Hashem loves us. Hashem knows what caused a person to do Avera is Yetzer Hara. The Yetzer Hara is standing on our right, and the whole day he wants to push us. To push us to do Avera. Ooh, he saw the Avera there, go! Oh, he saw the Avera there, go! So all this Yetzer Hara is looking for opportunities to cause a person to do Averot. And Hashem, by keeping mitzvot, mitzvot create a fence around you, and that fence keep away the Yetzer Hara. When you keep mitzvot, you have a certain siyata dishmaya, you have help from heaven, and that help will chase away the Yetzer Hara. Say the Gemara, at the beginning of time, for a person to be saved for the Yetzer Hara, he had to keep the whole Torah. 613 mitzvot. If you keep 600, you don't have this fence around you. Came David HaMelech, said, you can't, it's not nice. People are weaker. He said, you know what? You have to keep the whole Torah, don't get me wrong. But if you keep this 11, you'll have a fence around you. Until at the end of the time, so Habakkuk, that Bnei Israel are weak. And to force them to keep only 11 mitzvot, it's too much. Because he said, Habakkuk, you know what? If you keep Emunah, that alone will be a fence to save you from the Yetzer Hara. Meaning, you have to keep the rest of mitzvot, chas v'shalom. I'm not saying don't keep Shabbat, don't keep kasher. You have to keep everything. But Jews, by keeping emunah, that alone will help you to be saved from the yetzer hara. Like it's in Tehillim. It's in Tehillim. Ve'abotech b'shem, chesed, isovevenu. Someone that has faith in Hashem, he will have kindness around him. It says in the Midrash. Ve'abotech b'shem, someone that has faith in Hashem, afilu rasha. Even though he's a Rasha, there's a chesed around him. What does it mean? Even though he does Averot, even though there's a Yetzirah that come and force him to do Averot, but because he has Emunah in Hashem, he's a chesed around him. Which chesed? That's the fence that he created with that mitzvah, and that fence will help him not to do Averot. After all what the Yetzirah brought from us is to do Averot. Why? How does a person get someone to finish it? Someone to get depressed. He caused him to do Averot. Once a person does Averot, the guy gets depressed, he loses his Emunah. One, he loses his Emunah, finished. The Yitzhak said, this guy is mine. This guy is mine. That's what you will see. How does Yitzhak get a person? He make him stop going to shul. He make him stop going to classes. Once he doesn't go to classes, going to shul anymore. Now he's alone, right? I could kill him. It's finished. That's the Yetzirah. The Yetzirah is going to come, attack people, and stop them doing mitzvot. Because you know, as long as a person does mitzvot, he has this protection, especially Emunah. And that's what the Yetzirah wants, to destroy people. Now, how could I get Emunah? We live in such a low generation. We are not tzaddikim. We are small, weak people. We live in America with all the gashmiut around, with a huge screen TV, with a fancy cars, with a screen in the car, right? In your cell phone, you have everything. How could a person in today's age could have emunah? And the answer is, al yedei limud haTorah. A person has to study Torah. Like it says, Torah Hashem temima meshivat nafesh. Which means, what will give a person emunah, will revive his soul, is Torah. When a person learns Torah, Torah will help a person to improve his emunah. A lot of people go, Rabbi, what should I do for emunah? What segula is for emunah? Should I raise the red string? Should I put the hamsa all over? Should I put fish, right? Should I pour milk, garlic, onion, salad, or zimbabwe, cholent, right? They put cholent all over. What should I do to work on my emunah? Study Torah. Learn Torah. Why? Because Torah, that's the connection between us and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The reason why so many goyim fell, so many religion got destroyed, got ruined, they had the emunah, they believe, maybe they had the emunah more than us. But their emunah was based on nothing. They didn't have Torah. If you have emunah without Torah, it will not last long. The reason why all these goyim, all these all the religions, they disappear. It's because they had a fake emunah. They believe in Shtuyot. We believe in Hashem, but not only we believe in Hashem. We have the Torah, Kedusha, the holy Torah that, like oxygen, revive us every day and every day and every day and keep us connected with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I was, a couple months ago, I was driving from Deal to Lakewood. And last year. And I stopped at the gas station. And I stopped to fill up gas. And the guy was an Arab. He was filling me gas. So we start schmoozing, where are you from? I just ran away from Egypt. In Egypt was a balagan over there. So he ran away, he came to America. And he told me, you know, today for me it's Ramadan. I'm fasting. But here in America, I don't think I'm going to keep it. I don't think I will keep Ramadan anymore. For me, it's over. I'm not keeping it. And I was thinking to myself, look at this guy. He's in America for 2 months. For a couple months, and already he said, me, I don't need Ramadan anymore. And we have Jews, open Stony Brook, you have Jewish people that in the Holocaust, in Auschwitz, in Siberia, they make sure to keep Yom Kippur. In Auschwitz, they were keeping Tisha B'Av. In Auschwitz, they try to keep Shabbat. Why? Because their emunah, it's a strong emunah. Why they have a strong emunah? Because they have Torah, Kedusha. The Torah boosts the emunah of a person and makes it stay forever. And that's why, with that we could understand. It says, Malach HaMavet, Saro Shel Esav, the angel of Esav, went to fight with Yaakov Avinu. Right? Why did he go to fight with Yaakov? Why didn't he go with Avraham? Why didn't he go with Yitzchak? Why he waited for Yaakov Avinu? The answer is because Abraham, he was midat achesed. Yitzchak was gevura, tefila. Yaakov was tiferet, tiferet is Torah. Look at this. Abraham does chesed. These goyim do chesed. Why? Because from Abraham Avinu, children were goyim. So in the goyim also you could find chesed. Tefila came from Yitzchak. In the goyim came from Yitzchak. You also have goyim that pray, the Arabs, the machshima v'zicham, they pray 5 days, more than us. They pray more than us. But Torah was only in Yaakov Avinu. Tiferet, that's Torah, was only in Yaakov Avinu. Only Klal Yisrael have the Torah. That's why the Malach said, you want to do chesed? That's fine with me. You want to pray the whole day? It's fine with me. But Torah, chaz v'shalom. Why not? Because Torah, that's the oxygen that keep a Jew alive and keep him a strong emunah. Goyim, they have prayers. Goyim, they do charity. But because they don't have Torah, their emunah is not a strong emunah. And with time, their emunah will disappear, disappear, until they will kick their avodah zarah, their shtuyot, and turn their back on their idols. But we, because we have the Torah, that's why we always keep connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And I want to show you an amazing chidush. It says in the Sfarim HaKadoshim that when a person loses something, when you lose something, you should know. It's a call from Shamayim that your emunah is going down. Whenever you lose something, you lose your keys or you lose something, you should know. It's a siman from Hashem that you have to work on your emunah. So if you lose, obviously you don't trust so much in Hashem, Hashem wants to wake you up. Look at this. With this, you can understand an amazing thing. Yaakov Avinu is coming back from Lavan. He lost, what did he lost? Pachim ketanim, small jar. Yaakov Avinu, give up. It was one penny. Why are you going back for that? Yaakov Avinu said, Uy. If I lose something, that means my emunah is not good. How could it be? I am Tiferet. I'm learning Torah. I am the father of Torah. Torah, that will give emunah to a person like I just told you. If I lose something, I don't have emunah, that means my Torah is not good. If my Torah is not good, I'm finished. I'm finished. I'm like Esav and Ishmael. I just have chesed and tefillah. That's why Yaakov Avinu, he went back for the small things to show, no, I'm not losing anything. I still have emunah in Hashem. And that's why. Who came to fight with him right then?
Esav.
The Sarosh El Esav. The angel of Esav came to fight with him. Why? Because, are you nuts? He was coming to fight with him about emunah. He wasn't just like Mike Tyson coming to fight with him. He was coming to fight with him about emunah. Come on, give me a leg. These small things, you believe it from Hashem? Yes, even the penny come from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that's why Yaakov Avinu is the one that went back, because his midah was Tiferet. Tiferet stands for Torah. Torah. And that's why it says, and emunah come by studying Torah. That's why Sukkot is a chag of Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu, why? Because Sukkot stands for emunah. I live alone in my house, and I go to a small sukkah, and the HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I completely trust in you. And it says in Sfarim HaKadoshim that Sukkot stands for Yaakov Avinu. What's the connection between Yaakov and Sukkot? The answer is, a person could have a right emunah only if he studied Torah. If a person doesn't learn Torah, you cannot have your emunah with time will disappear. Like the nation of the world. They do chesed, they pray. But they don't have Torah, eventually the emunah gets lost. And that's why Yaakov Avinu went back. To show my emunah is strong. Me that learn Torah cannot be, I lose something. And with this also, I would like to explain a little more. It's in the parasha. Bereshit bara Elohim. Two words. Bereshit bara. Say Rashi. Bereshit. Why bet Reshit? Two Reshit. These two things on earth in this world that are called Reshit. One of them is Torah. One of them is Am Israel. At the beginning of the Torah, Hashem is telling us, you know what will help Bnei Israel to stay alive? Is Torah. The world was created to last. When Hashem created the world, at the beginning he saw that Israel received the Torah. And only the Torah could keep a nation alive. So at the beginning of the Torah, Hashem said, Bishvil Israel, Bishvil Torah, that will keep people going alive. And like I just told you, listen to this, an amazing chidush. Amazing chidush. Our nation stay around because we have faith in Hashem. How do we have such a strong faith that other nations don't have? It's because we study Torah. Say the chidah. He saw an amazing chidush. Bereshit, if I go around and I ask you, what is a pasuk in the whole entire Torah that stands for emunah? go through the Torah, right? Scan it. What is the, I'm sure you could do it. What is the pasuk that stands the most, that reminds you the most emuna? Which pasuk? No? No. The pasuk that reminds you the most emuna is, of course, Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. That way when they go to kill a person, Al Kiddush Hashem, what does he scream? Shema Yisrael! Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad! I have emunah, everything from Hashem. Bereshit bara, say the chida, with a kolel, two kolel, it's the same numerical value that the pasuk, Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Go at home and do the math. Bereshit bara, plus two, because each word is a kolel, it's called a kolel. So all together, if I'm not mistaken, is 11, 18. The same gematria that the pasuk, Shema Israel Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. Why? Hashem at the beginning of the Torah wants to teach us. You know how to keep the world alive. You know how to stay alive. Av emuna. If you have emuna, you could make it. How you have emuna? By learning Torah. Right? Look at this. Bereshit bara. What's the next word? Elokim. Let's take the last letter of the first three words. Bereshit, the last letter is Taf. Bara is Aleph. Elohim is Mem. What is it? Emet. What is Emet? It's?
Emuna.
No, Emet stands for Torah. Torah, Emet, Natalanu. We sing in Igdal, right? Torah, Emet, Natalanu. Emet stands for Torah. So the Pasuk is telling us, Bereshit, Bara. If you want to have Emuna, like Shema Yisrael, Adrenu Alo Echad, do the Elohim. Then you have the Emet. By learning Torah, that will give a person emunah. So at the beginning of the Torah, Akrimon is teaching us how a person could survive in this world. How could a person survive in this world is only by learning Torah. And I want to share with you an amazing chidush from the Ben Ishchai. Say the Ben Ishchai. Look at this. It's in the pasuk. Ve'aretz hayta, next pasuk. Ve'aretz hayta tov vavohu v'choshech al penei teom. When the earth was empty with darkness upon the surface of the deep, and the divine presence was above the water. So it says like this. Ve'aretz hayta tohu vavohu. Says the Ben Ishchai, Aretz is me, you, human being. We are, because min ha'adama, we come from earth. Exactly. Ve'aretz hayta tohu vavohu. A person in this world is lost. He has a lot of desire, a lot of ta'avot. He ran after this avera, he ran after money, he ran after everything, all the averot. Ve'aretz. Man is a big balagan. A big balagan. Look, go outside. People don't have Torah. Look, these Arabs. They don't have Torah. They're like animals. Animals. They take a knife and they go kill little children. Where is your heart? Where is your heart? You don't have a heart? Well, a man without a Torah is like tohu vavohu. He's like animals. How could you go with a knife? Where is the Nazis? Yimach shemah vezichram. The German. Where is your heart? You don't have a heart? You don't have a heart to go shoot like this a little baby? Where is your heart? To burn babies? To send them to the gas chamber? Where is your heart? A person without Torah is an animal. A person don't study Torah is a behema, chaya ra'ah. Like said by Ishmael, pere Adam. Pere Adam. Usually you said Adam tov, Adam ra. First of all, Adam, then the adjective. By Ishmael, it doesn't say Adam pere. Pere Adam. He's not a human being. They are pere Adam. Pere Adam. Why? Because they don't have Torah. They do chesed, right? They give millions of dollars to tzedakah. They pray five times a day. But their emunah was nothing. Why? Because without Torah, you are nothing. So look what it says. Ve'aretz, Zegel Ben Ishchai. Ve'aretz hayta tohu vavohu. That's man that is empty. Is balagan. Is all mixed up with nonsense. Ve'choshech al penei teom. And darkness was on the surface of earth. What is darkness? That's the Yetzer Hara. The Yetzer Hara come and make our life dark. Look, people that Chacham Ovadia Yosef. Look, Chacham Ovadia Yosef. Always happy, always with simcha, always making jokes, always smacking people, always with simcha. Right? Why? A person that learned Torah, he has Yetzer Hara come and try to darken our life. To look, to make our life as miserable as possible. A person that learned Torah, he has simcha. So v'choshech al penei teom, it's Yetzer Hara. V'ruach Elohim. And the spirit of Hashem. What is it? So Ben Ishchai, that's the Yetzer HaTov. The Yetzer HaTov and come, Al Pene Amayim. The Yetzer HaTov come to man and tell him, you won't survive. Al Pene Amayim, you have to go with water. En Mayim Ela Torah. So, if you do that, What's the next word of the pasuk? Vayomer Elohim, Yehi Or. Then you have light. Then you will have light. The Ben Yisrael said, look, in this pasuk, HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us the how to go through this world and make it. If you are in the darkness, you are lost, the Yetzer is trying to destroy you, so you light. Know how to have light? Al Penei HaMayim. Go in the place where there is water and Mayim El HaTorah. So a person, if he wants to have Emunah, a person wants to have Emunah, to go through in this world, the only thing he could do is, the thing he should do is, of course, learning Torah. Now look at this. The first word in the Torah is Bereshit. The last word in the Torah is Israel. We all heard already this speech that the last letter and the first letter is the word Lev. Lev. Lev means heart. So the rabbi asked a simple question. If the Torah wants to tell me that Torah is Lev, why the Torah doesn't start with a Lamed and finish with a Bet? Why would it opposite? The last letter is Vet, is Lamed. And the first one is Lamed, is Bet. So you have Bet and then Lamed. Do the opposite. Start the Torah with Lamed and finish with Vet. So you only have the Lev, only on Simcha Torah, when you read right away Zadav Berakha and Bereshit. So the only time when you see Lev, it's only when you finish the Torah. Why? The rabbi wanted to teach it like this. Torah is not a book. That a lot of time a person read a book, oh, very nice book, I finished it. In the Geniza. Next, what's the next book? A person studies the whole Torah. Some people might think, I read this book already, finished. How many times? Aji, every year I went to the Torah. I learned this Gemara. How many times? I finished it. Next, let's do something else. The Torah said, no. You want to have a lev, you won't survive, because a body without a heart is nothing. You want to have a heart, you won't survive. Emunah comes from the lev. It's only if you learn the Torah again and again and again. So only when you finish the Torah and you start again, then you have a lev. The same way a person needs oxygen every day to breathe, no one will think, I breathed yesterday. That's it. Tomorrow, I'm not breathing. I breathed yesterday. Shote. Yesterday, I ate a meal. Today, I'm not eating. Shote. So to a person cannot say, I learned Torah already. I did Daf Yomi. I finished the Shas. Now, I'm moving to Hawaii with my cigar and sitting the whole day on the hammock. Shtuyot. Torah is the oxygen of the Jewish people. This was keep us alive. And I want to finish with the following Chiddush. We know that at the end of the days, it says in the Nach, in Ovadia actually, Vayei bet Yaakov esh, ubet Yosef lahava, ubet Esav lekash, vedalku ba'em ve'achlum. At the end of the days, the house of Yaakov will be like fire. And the house of Yosef will be like a flame. And Esav will be like straw. They will get burned, Bezrat Hashem, soon with all this in their eyes, the come of Mashiach, and our own enemy will be destroyed. Look at this. The Pasuk is telling us that Bet Yaakov will be fire. Yaakov will be fire. Bet Yosef will be lava, the flame. And Esav will be lekash. At the beginning of the Torah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted already to be meramez this issue. You should know now I create this world. You're going to have to go through a lot of suffering. A lot of difficult things, but you should know. Here it's only the beginning. But I want to show you a little bit, a little remez, a little boost, that at the end, everything will be good. Look at this. Bereshit. If you take the word Bereshit, and you, let's split it. So from Bereshit, let's take the Esh. Esh, it's fire. Who was fire? Bet Yaakov. I just told you the Pasuk. Bet Yaakov will be fire. Yosef will be Lehava, will be a flame. And Esav, Lekash. It says in the Midrash, that when we say Yosef, it's not Dafka Yosef. It's Rachel and her children. Like we saw in the story of Aman. Who killed Aman? Mordechai. From which Shevet come Mordechai? From Binyamin. Mordechai Yemini. He came for Binyamin. And the rabbi explained us that Rachel, she will have the power to destroy Amalek, to destroy Esav. Look at this. Esh, from the word Bereshit, stands for Yaakov. Taf, let's take the Taf from Bereshit, is the same numerical value that Kash, straw. Taf is 400, Kash is 400. I'm left with which letter from Bereshit? Bet, Resh, Yud. Look at this. Again, one more time. Esh is for Bet Yaakov Le'esh. Taf of Bereshit, Gematria 400, that Kash. We are left with Bet, Resh, Yud. What is Bet, Resh, Yud? Binyamin, Rachel, Yosef.
Wow.
Binyamin, Rachel, Yosef. Hashem wanted to show at the beginning, look, everything is going to be very hard, but don't worry. At the end of the days, You will love the fire from Yaakov. The nation of the world will be like straw. And you will love the power of Rachel Imenu through Yosef and Binyamin that will destroy your enemies. Why Yosef and Binyamin? Why Rachel? Because they stand for Emunah. They stand for Emunah. Binyamin was born after they left Lavan. Lavan, all his concept was to be Mebalbel. To be Mebalbel people, there is no Emunah. There is no Lavan. Lev, Nun. Nun is Shari Binah. He wanted to be Bal. Bal Mebalbel. He wanted to mix up the no Nun. There is no Akash Baruch Hu, all his Truyot. Like he told Yaakov, if I want, I could really arm you. But you God tell me not. You have a power to arm you? Who are you? Who are you? Shne Stirot. Who are you? But that's a Lavan. Lavan want to bring confusion in Am Israel. And that's why Binyamin wasn't exposed at all to Lavan. At all. Yosef is the first one that went to Galut. He went to Galut and we saw how many times he experienced Nisyonot and he proved his Emunah. By Potiphar, by the jail, every time non-stop he was proving his Emunah. Emunah, why? Because it says the 14 years he learned with Yosef, with his father, there were 14 years. Why Yaakov only picked him? Because he learned with him only Emunah. For 14 years, he told him, Masechet Emunah. Was one Masechet with a billion of Perakim, and you will need this because you will go to Galut. And that's why in the Pasuk, at the beginning of the Torah, Bereshit, you should know, one day Bet Yaakov will be fire. Then you will have Rachel through Binyamin and Yosef. They will destroy our nation, will be cash like straw. And that's the Berakha I want to give it to you. That when we open the news, we open the newspaper, we see so many people are suffering. So many people are suffering. And a lot of us, we get a little smack on our Emunah. On our Emunah, after all. Look, there are rabbis, there are tzaddikim, there are little children, the women, they didn't do any averot. Why is HaKadosh Baruch Hu hurting them? And a lot of people, they might lose their Emunah. Lose Emunah. Oh, maybe our Torah is wrong, Chaz v'Shalom. Maybe our Torah is wrong, right? That's why during those terrible times, a person has to go and learn even more Torah. More Torah, why? To be mitchazek is Emunah. Like it says, the Chafetz Chaim said, at the end of the days, the Nisayon will be Emunah. The Yetzirah will try as much as possible to take the faith of people. And only by studying Torah, we will pass this Nisayon and we will zochit the Geulah. Like it says,